Welcome back to the Suraj Podcast. In the previous episode, we talked about Bidhi Chand telling the wives of Guru Arjan about a time in his youth when he almost got caught stealing. He took the help of a Sikh during that episode, and he agreed that he would go visit Guru Arjan and become his Sikh after the ordeal. And that's where chapter 2 begins. So Bidhi Chand is telling the wives of Guru Arjan that he went with a Sikh to Amritsar to meet Guru Arjan Dev Ji. Bidhi Chand was bewildered and just in awe when the first time he saw Guru Arjan. You know, there was a splendor to his darshan. He's telling the wives of Guru Arjan. He's saying that he saluted Guru Arjan while the Sikh that he was with was telling Guru Arjan the whole story about what happened. So Guru Arjan got really happy and initiated me as a Sikh. So he gave me charan pal. And this is a ceremony that we talked about before, where there's water being stirred by the Guru's foot, and some of that's placed in the mouth, the eyes, and the hair of the Sikh. So after this initiation, Guru Arjan gave me some teachings, saying that, you know, I should forever meditate upon Satnam, the true name of the Divine. He also told me that I should leave this life as a thief, and that I should read Gurbani and listen to Gurbani. And I told Guru Arjan that, well, this life is all I know. I can't give up this life as a thief, and I'll tell you the truth about that. And Guru Arjan, listening to this, laughed and said, you know, okay, if you can't give this life up as a thief, then be a thief for good. You know, whatever you steal, give to the needy, the ones who need food, the ones who don't have anything in their pocket, give to them. You know, by feeding them, you'll be doing a great service to humanity. From those who have a lot, well, you can take a little and give out to the poor. So do this if you can't leave this lifestyle as a thief. So listening to these teachings, you know, I accepted them. I stayed in Amritsar for some days after that. And, you know, I spent my time helping out, doing seva, doing selfless service wherever I could. Then, you know, after having a good laugh with the Sikh who I was with, you know, I headed back to my maternal village, Sirhadi. So whenever I had a desire to steal, you know, I'd go out and I would steal, but then whatever I had, I would give to the poor. And while during this, you know, whatever, you know, event that I went on, I always remembered the Guru while I was doing this stealing as well. So one day I was just relaxing and this Brahmin woman came up to me and she says, you know, oh Sikh, we heard about your good name in this village. We heard about how you help out the poor. My family's extremely poor. We don't have anything to eat. We only have a few clothes. You know, our life is very, very difficult. You know, we have a very young daughter who needs to get married, and we can't afford to marry her off. You know, we don't even have enough to eat every day. We eat every second day. So hearing this, I asked the woman, well, you know, how much money would you need for you to marry off your daughter and for you to be happy? You know, tell me the truth of how much you exactly need. And the woman replied that, you know, we would need about 500 rupees. You know, that would cover the full wedding for our daughter. So, you know, I says to her, I says, you know, I'll give you the money. I'll be back in about 5 days. She got really happy about this. She went home. You know, I sat there. I was trying to figure a way out to get this money. And then I remembered that the wives of Jahangir, so Jahangir is the father of Shah Jahan. So now we are going back in some time during Guru Arjan Dev Ji's time. So during that time, the emperor was Jahangir. So he says, I remember that the wives of Jahangir were traveling around a village not too far from here. And so I headed towards that direction. You know, I scouted out the property, you know, during the day, and then at night I stayed there. In the middle of the night, you know, I was able to get into that area where the wives were sleeping with their servants. You know, near them were all these boxes of jewelry and money. So I sat there, you know, opening these boxes. I found one that was just filled with money. So in this box, there was a bunch of bags, which had, you know, different amounts of money in them. I saw a bag, you know, that had 500 rupees in it. So I just took that one bag. That's all I took. You know, there's all these other boxes there with all sorts of jewelry that was, you know, very expensive. You know, with jewels, rubies, pearls, diamonds on them. I left all of that. You know, I remembered the Guru's teachings that only take what I need to and give to the poor. So I took this you know, I hid it on me and then I escaped in the night. So when I returned, I gave that money to the Brahmin woman, who was then able to have this wedding for her daughter. You know, I took nothing else. So the next morning, the wives woke up and they saw that, you know, the boxes of jewelry were open, but nothing was taken out. They only saw that one bag was taken out. So they went to Jahangir and then told them about this, saying that, you know, somebody had come into the room, somebody had stole 500 rupees worth of a bag, but, you know, they left all these other boxes with all the jewelry in it. You know, those are worth thousands and thousands of rupees, you know. Why would somebody do this? This makes no sense, you know. So Jahangir gets extremely pissed. And in the village where the wives were and the surrounding villages, he sends the army in and brutalizes everybody, saying that, you know, if you don't tell me who stole the money, then, you know, we'll hang the entire village. You know, the villagers of my maternal village where I was living, some of them went to that village, you know, and seeing the pain and you know, kind of the difficult spot of where they were, they had a conversation with the villagers, and they said, you know, somebody in our village is able to help, and we believe that, you know, he's helped many people before. He can probably help you guys out now. So they came to me, and they started requesting my help, saying that, you know, many of their villagers were in prison, some of them were being tortured, you know, and listening to the plight of that village. From the villagers, I said, you know, there must be a way I can make this right. There must be a way that I can make everybody happy here. So I went with them and I said, you know, we'll go to Jahangir and we'll sort this out. So I went with them. You know, I knew that, you know, Guru Arjan wouldn't let not even one hair on my head be bent. You know, I had no fear in my mind. I had complete faith. So they brought me into the court, you know, sitting there, and Jahangir is looking at me and he says, you know, you're the one who stole the goods, aren't you? And I said, yes, you know, what you said is true, but you'll be amazed if I could tell you the full truth here. So Jahangir said, yeah, I don't understand why you only took a little bit. You know, there was jewelry with rubies and pearls and, you know, diamonds on them. You took none of that. You only took the small bag. So either you tell me the truth now about why you did this, or I'll kill you. So I told Jahangir that, well, first of all, Guru Arjan is my guru, and he's my master, and he has his hand on my head right now, protecting me. And he is the one who told me that, you know, I should steal, but if I steal, I should steal for good. You know, and taking these instructions, it was with these instructions that I did what I did. You know, I gave that small bag that I took, I gave to a really poor Brahmin who had to marry off her daughter. You know, they had nothing else in the house. So I told Jahangir that, you know, I didn't use any of that money for myself. It was only for that poor woman. You know, I don't have any desire to steal for myself. But if somebody needs help, you know, I'll quickly get it for them. When Jahangir heard the name of Guru Arjan, he immediately just bowed his head down and he let everybody out, everybody free, even me and all the villagers. So this is how I got out of punishment from the various crimes of stealing that, you know, I had committed. And Bidhi Chand then concludes in saying that, you know, I never kept anything I stole, you know, it was always for others. So after Bidhi Chand says this, you know, Mata Nanaki is just sitting there and she's amazed and she's thinking, well, let's see if this guy will do something for me. I want to test Bidhi Chand out here. And at the same time, Guru Hargobind's sitting there and he's listening and he's just laughing, saying, oh man, Bidhi Chand, you are truly like nobody else is like you. You're a great and super sharp Guru Sikh. So then Mata Nanaki says, you know, you've helped so many people out with your quick wit and deception. You know, like the time when you stole the two horses, you've pleased Guru Hargobind in so many ways, but now I have a request for you. So please help me out such that, you know, you'll forever live in peace. So Bidhi Chand says, you know, wow, you know, I'm so fortunate that, first of all, I please you with my story. And now that, you know, you're asking me for help. So, you know, I couldn't be happier. My body is going to die anyway. So if it dies in your service, then, you know, what's better than that? So Mata Nanaki hears this and says, well, wherever the wives of Jahangir are, I want you to go there right now and steal the jewelry from them. The ones with, you know, the diamonds and the pearls on them, the ones that are really expensive, I want that jewelry. So listening to this, Bidhi Chand says, you know, absolutely, I'll go. You know, and taking permission from Guru Hargobind, he leaves, but not before receiving a blessing from Mata Nanaki as well, saying that, you know, may your body forever, you know, experience bliss, may it never succumb to any illnesses, and you truly are a great warrior of the Guru. So this is where chapter 2 ends. And in the next chapter, we'll pick up where Bidhi Chand goes on this mission to steal jewelry from the wives of the emperor. Sarega, gaj gaj kara jaave, Guru Arjan saab ke man paave, nihal ho jaave, sab sareya.